what Einstein did in 1905, his first theory of relativity, that would be enough for most people. But he had another idea, a more powerful idea, which came together in 1915 when he was in his mid-30s, the middle of World War I, and it's called general relativity. And it's a magnificent idea. If he hadn't come up with it, I doubt if anybody else would have in the more than century since then. And it's a notion of explaining how all of space and time and all of matter and everything's organized. And what's amazing is instead of it being a long, complicated, dull thing, he got it down to two little symbols. And this was extraordinary, he thought. Who had created a universe where all the complexity we see, the spinning of the Earth around the Sun, how the galaxy moves, if it moves at all, that all this could be explained in terms of two simple symbols? And he thought this was fabulous. And then he looked at his symbols, and he realized, they predicted that the universe was expanding. He asked his astronomer friends, 1917, 1918, is the universe in fact expanding? And they said, no, it's static. They thought at that time, the universe was just the Milky Way galaxy, a whole bunch of stars floating there in space. And beyond there, there was just an empty void. It was sort of like Donald Trump's brain. There was just angry magnetic fields full of nothing. And Einstein thought, are you sure? And they said, well, that's kind of what the universe is like. So he had to change that beautiful, simple equation and had to put in an extra term, which he symbolized by the lambda. And instead of thinking, God or the old one or whatever force there is behind the universe had made something very simple for us to discover, there's this ugly equation, this additional term that sort of canceled the expansion. Anyways, about 10 years later, 1929, Edwin Hubble in California and other people said, oy, were we wrong. They probably didn't say the word oy. Were we wrong, they said. The universe is expanding after all. And Einstein thought, the good news is I get to take away the lambda, that extra term. I can go back to that beautiful, simple, clear thing I discovered back in 1915 in general relativity. And that's okay. That's an allowable mistake. I don't think that's his greatest mistake. The great mistake came after that. He drew a psychological conclusion. He concluded that he was wrong to have listened to experimental evidence. Because he believed that the universe should be crisp and clear and exact, from now on, if he had those beliefs and experimental evidence came up that contradicted it, he could ignore it. Remember, he would have been right. He would have been right to ignore all the evidence that the astronomers thought about the shape of the universe. They were wrong for 10 years. Well, it turns out in the late 1920s, when Einstein had this breakthrough or this idea, that's when quantum mechanics was coming in, the study of the ultra-small, electrons, things like that. And they seemed to move around, not in the clear, beautiful ways that Einstein wanted, but there's randomness and chance and probability. And Einstein thought, okay, that's, you know, the limits of our technical abilities. Our observations only see this fuzziness, but if we have better tools, we'll be able to see things more exactly. Einstein thought that things like uncertainty were just a temporary stage in mankind's development. But the physicists said, no, the evidence is really clear. And Einstein said, oh, I was burned once before with that lambda and the expansion of the universe. I'm not going to be burned again. So he dug in. He doubled up. And as time went on, the evidence for quantum mechanics, for this randomness and probability on the ultra-small, that evidence became stronger and stronger. But Einstein was stuck. He couldn't let go. He just thought, if I'd held my confidence for 10 years before, I would have been okay. Well, maybe it might be 20 years. Maybe it might be beyond my lifetime. But I'm sure, Einstein thought, I'm sure that the universe can't be disordered. That's why he said, God does not play dice with the universe. And his good friend Niels Bohr said, Einstein, stop telling God what to do.